morning. Welcome to St. Thomas this morning. Welcome to a house of prayer in the valley here. So glad that we're open for business and that we are Chris Klutz calls, he was the acting mayor at our anniversary, he calls this an iconic building in Chilliwack, this beautiful historic site. So glad we can still have it open and be functioning here through the week many times. Thank you, kids, for ringing the bells this morning. They sounded lovely as our call to prayer and our call to gather. A couple of announcements before we continue with the service. Just saying that yesterday we had a wonderful Epiphany retreat. There were 16 of us there, and it was just lovely. Did you like that, Sharon? Awesome. Yeah, it was lovely. And it was lovely to have different ages. Hey, Ashley, even little Victoria was there and different ones. So it was great. Yeah, it was a good morning. And thank you, Leslie, to your exquisite facilitation of that event. It was lovely. Also wanted to make known that this week coming up on Saturday night is the Double Digits Youth Junior Youth Group that's gathering for 10 years plus. And we're going to be meeting at our house at Cultus Lake, so we can have a bonfire maybe, or play some games, eat pizza, and then also just be studying together ways to pray, all the different ways we can pray. So that's this Saturday at 4:30. See me or the website for details. Today is the baptism of our Lord. It's a day we celebrate Jesus' baptism following the birth and following the wise men coming, which we celebrated last week of Epiphany. Now we move on to the life of Christ in his baptism. So I look forward to that throughout this service. But in order to do that, we're going to bless the water so that when you come up for communion, you have some blessed water here to dip your hand in to remember the baptism of our Lord and our own baptisms if we have been baptized. So we'll do that now. One thing we're going to also do this today, because I've had some people ask, people maybe who don't have an Anglican background, and they're asking, you know, what's this? You know, when we cross, do the sign of the cross. And I just want to invite you to all do the sign of the cross this morning and learn what that is or how that is if it's new to you, and know that it's for everybody. And you can do it any time of the morning, noon, or night, whenever you feel led to remember God and remember the Trinity. So let's practice. We first start, we use three fingers. I mean, it doesn't really matter, but typically you can use three fingers, which is a sign of the Trinity. We put them together and we go in the name of our Creator, our Christ. We go down to our belly and then over to our left shoulder, Holy Spirit. Creator, Christ, Holy Spirit. So feel free to do that if you're interested. There's different times we plan to do it in the service, and you'll see when some people do it. But you can do it whenever you feel led to remember God's presence, receive God's love in a special way at that moment. Thank you, Almighty God, for the gift of water. Over water, the Holy Spirit moved in the beginning of creation. Through water, you led the children of Israel out of their bondage in Egypt into the land of promise. Water, your son Jesus received the baptism of John and was anointed by the Holy Spirit as the Messiah, the Christ, to lead us through his death and resurrection from the bondage of sin into everlasting life. Thank you, Father, for the water of baptism. In it we are buried with Christ in his death, and by it we share in his resurrection. But we are reborn by the Holy Spirit. Therefore, in joyful obedience to your Son, we bring into fellowship those who come to him in faith, baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Now sanctify this water by the power of your Holy Spirit, that those who are here cleansed from sin and born again may continue forever in the risen life of Jesus Christ, our Savior. To him, to you, and to the Holy Spirit be all honor, glory, now and forever. Now into a moment of quiet to breathe in the love of God and prepare for worship together. Christ, and the love of God and of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let us pray. All-loving God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hidden. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please stand as you're able for the opening song. Opening song.
Here in this place, new light is streaming. Now is the darkness vanished away. See in this space, our fears and our dreamings brought you to you in the light of this day. Gather us in the lost and forsaken. Gather us in the blind and the lame. Call to us now, awaken, we shall arise at the sound of our name. We are the young, our lives are a mystery. We are the old who yearn for your face. We have been sown throughout all of history, called to be light to the whole human race. Gather us in, the rich and the haughty. Gather us in, the proud and the strong. Give us a heart so meek and so lowly. Give us the courage to enter the song. Here we will take the wine and the water. Here we will take the bread of new birth. Here you shall call your sons and your daughters, call us anew to be salt for the earth. Give us to drink the wine of compassion, give us to eat the bread that is you. Nourish us well and teach us to fashion lives that are holy and hearts that are true. Not in the dark of buildings confining, not in some heaven light years away, but here in this place the new light is shining. Now is the kingdom, now is the day. Gather us in and hold us forever. Gather us in and make us your own. Gather us in, all people together, power of love in our flesh and our bone.
Let us pray. Eternal, who at the baptism of Jesus revealed him to be your Son, anointing him with the Holy Spirit, keeping your children born of water and the Spirit faithful to their calling through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Just so we know, if children would like to go up, for story time and activity, Miss Audrey will be leading today. So you can go up to the upper room for children's circle if you like, or you can bring a clipboard and activities to your seat or play at the back, whatever works for you. I'm just noticing the screen is a bit blinking today. Anyone else notice? So if it gets continues to do that and it's annoying, I just invite you to use your bulletin and to turn to the blue hymn book that's in your pew. If you have your bulletin and the blue hymn book, you have everything. You don't need to look up at the screen. And if it gets really bad, Gracie, then we'll just turn it off and use the hymn book. Okay? Thank you.
Rage, kingdoms rise and fall. There is still one king reigning over all. So I will not fear, for this truth remains that my God is the Ancient of Days. None above stand. All the power, all the glory, I will trust in his name, for my God is the Ancient of Days. Though the dread of night overwhelms my soul, he is of the Ancient of Days. None above him, none before him, all of time in his hands, for his throne it shall remain and ever stand. All the power, all the glory, I will trust in his name, for my God is the Ancient.
Please be seated for the readings.
A reading from the book of Genesis. In the beginning, when God created the heavens and the earth was a formless void, and darkness covered the face of the deep, while a wind from God swept over the face of the waters. Then God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. And God saw the light was good, and God separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day, and the darkness he called night. And there was evening, and there was morning, the first day.
Ascribe to the Lord, you gods. Ascribe to God glory, and ascribe to God the glory due the divine name. Worship God in the beauty of holiness. The voice of God is upon the waters. The voice of God, the glory of God thunders and is upon the mighty waters. The voice of God is a powerful voice. The voice of God is a voice of splendor. The voice of God breaks the cedar trees. God breaks the cedars of Lebanon and makes Lebanon skip like a calf and Mount Hermon like a young wild ox. The voice of God splits the flames of fire. The voice of God shakes the wilderness and shakes the wilderness of Kadesh. The voice of God makes the oak trees writhe and strips the forests bare. And in the temple of the Lord, all are crying glory. God sits enthroned above the flood. God sits enthroned as sovereign forevermore. God shall give strength to his people. God shall give his people the blessing of peace.
A reading from the book of Acts. While Apollos was in Corinth, Paul passed through the interior regions and came to Ephesus, where he found some disciples. He said to them, "Did you receive the Holy Spirit when you became believers?" They replied, "No, we have not even heard that there is a Holy Spirit." Then he said, "Into what then were you baptized?" They answered, "Into John's baptism." Paul said, "John baptized with the baptism of repentance, telling the people to believe in the one who was to come after him, that is, in Jesus." On hearing this, they were baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus. When Paul had laid his hands on them, the Holy Spirit came upon them, and they spoke in tongues and prophesied. Altogether, there were about 12 of them. Hear what the Spirit is saying to us today.
Please stand as you're able as we sing the gradual hymn and turn to face the gospel book as it's processed down the aisle today. The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Mark. John the Baptizer appeared in the wilderness, proclaiming a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins. And people from the whole Judean countryside and all the people of Jerusalem were going out to meet him and were baptized by him in the river Jordan, confessing their sins. Now John was clothed with camel's hair, with a leather belt around his waist, and he ate locusts and wild honey. He proclaimed, "The one who is more powerful than I is coming after me. I am not worthy to stoop down and untie the thong of his sandals. I have baptized you with water, but he will baptize you with the Holy Spirit." In those days, Jesus came from Nazareth of Galilee and was baptized by John in the Jordan. And just as he was coming up out of the water, he saw the heavens torn apart and the Spirit descending like a dove on him. And a voice came from heaven, "You are my Son, the Beloved. With you I..." The Gospel of Christ. Nice to be right down here by the Paschal candle. It's usually tucked away up at the back, but on feast days we bring her out and light her up in all of her glory to celebrate today the baptism of our Lord. God speaks and things happen. Today's readings show us a few things that happen when God's voice goes out. And as we listen to God's voice, I invite you today to put on your imagination caps. Remember those from kindergarten? We should have never put them away. But at age 11, they say we stop using our imagination, and I think that's a very sad thing. So let's put on our imagination caps, because these writers are tapping into some beautiful imagery, some beautiful metaphors. And they're lovely to hear about. So I invite you to also use the eyes of your heart and to look and see and to open your heart to feel what happens when God speaks. From the psalm, God's voice is powerful, a voice of splendor. I looked up the word splendor in the dictionary to get a fresh glance at its meaning. And I read, "Splendor is a great brightness, a brilliancy, a magnificence." God's voice is very bright. It's very epiphany, as we're in that season now and celebrated yesterday so beautifully. Our readings today start with Genesis 1:1, a new beginning, which is very fitting for what we're experiencing now to some degree, is entering into a new beginning of 2024. So with our imagination caps on, we can envision as we read, in the beginning, when God created the heavens and the earth, the earth was formless. It was a formless void with a covering of darkness. Then a wind from God, perhaps God's breath, swept over the face of the waters. And then we hear God's voice. God said, "Let there be light." God's splendor or brilliancy said, "Let there be brightness." And God saw that the light was good. The psalmist today speaks mostly about God's voice and how it is in everything. The voice of God is upon the waters and in the thunder, in the quiet stillness of water, but also in the loud thunder that roars, in the whispers of the ripples of the lake, and in the huge storms that we face in life. And this raging of the storms could cause us to not want to listen to that voice, but in the stillness, may we hear, "I love you," from God. And even in the thunder and in the storms, may we hear, "I love you and I mean it." What if somehow, in the brilliancy of God's voice, we hear God's love, even if the breaking of cedar trees that make Lebanon skip like a calf sound a bit harsh, and the shaking of the wilderness? And I have heard that you have to shake ground sometimes for seeds to sprout, for life to come. The mustard seed apparently won't even burst or come into life unless it is burst or it's disturbed in some way. And so even the shaking and these loud things that happen in life can be used for good. God's voice splits the flames of fires, makes the oak trees writhe, and I don't know what that's about, and stripping forests bare. But in all of it, could we hear, with our imagination caps on, "I love you, I love you, I love you." That the voice of God in all sound is not to bring fear, but to break it. To break it with God's extravagant love pouring out. Where there is darkness, may God's light and grace abound even more. In today's psalm, the voice of God is mentioned quite a few times, as I mentioned, with God giving strength and blessing of peace. The voice of God is to give strength and the blessing of peace. There seems to always be a response to God's voice being heard. The response to the voice of God in the psalm is, "All cry out glory in the temple." Well, there's a word used to reference God's glory filling the temple. This word is not in the Bible, but is rooted in the Old Testament and used by the rabbis for the nearness or presence of God to the people. The word is Shekinah. Shekinah in Hebrew means dwelling. Shekinah, glory of God. The Shekinah, the dwelling of God in God's glory. Glory, God dwells here, the Shekinah. In the Old Testament, the Shekinah shone through the cloud that led the Hebrew people. And the New Testament proclaims that God has come to dwell with humanity in Jesus Christ. The Shekinah. And the Word became flesh and lived among us. And we have seen his glory, the glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. And we experience also the presence of the Holy Spirit as a divine indwelling. God's presence. God dwells around us, within us, and in the many sounds of silence, thunder, in the splitting of wood and the cracking and crackling of flickering flames. God's voice. It's very timely, these scriptures today, because this Friday we're starting a new series for 4 weeks in our Circle of Grace on listening to the voice of God. And together we'll listen and we'll take time for that. We'll learn how to discern God's voice and how to share God's voice with others. God's voice is also heard in the gospel today. I just want to say you're all invited on Fridays. You don't have to come all the time, but if you want to come for these 4 weeks, you're welcome. Catherine Murray is leading the course. It's going to be great. John the baptizer in today's gospel also shares, in this gospel, there's a bit about God's voice if you want to hear it again. John the baptizer acknowledged and made space for God's presence and for this greater power. And he participated with it. He baptized people, which is his to do, and then he baptized Jesus, who would in turn then go and baptize with the Holy Spirit. And baptizing with the Holy Spirit just means that that power from Christ goes out to many, many others. Paul speaks of this baptism happening in the epistle we read today. When he's going into Corinth, he asks when he enters the city, "Did you receive the Holy Spirit when you became believers?" "No," the people said, "we have not. We've not even heard that there is a Holy Spirit." So John baptized with water for repentance, calling people to change as the kingdom of heaven is near. He went about telling people to believe in the one who was to come, Jesus. And then the early church was baptized in water again in the name of Jesus. And then Paul laid hands on them after Pentecost, and the Holy Spirit came upon them, and they spoke in tongues and prophesied. Exciting times. Who said the Christian life is boring? Our spiritual lives grow and they develop. No one act or one sacrament or one experience with God is the end mark. God is eternal, and so are God's blessings. They are only the next invitations to come, and they appear at the right time. Genesis began with God creating something new. God moved over the water in wind, in breath. And now, just as Jesus is about to begin something new, a new ministry, declaring the kingdom of love has come, Jesus comes up and breaks through the water. Let's use our imagination again. Jesus sees the heavens torn open, torn apart, and the Spirit descending like a dove on him. Not as a dove, but like a dove. Wind, maybe wings, something coming down. Maybe it's God's breath in the wind of the wings. And we hear God's voice. "You are my son, the beloved. With you I am well pleased." What I find fascinating about this is that Jesus had not even yet begun his ministry. He had not yet done one marvelous thing that we know about. And yet God is so very pleased with him. God is pleased with Jesus without Jesus' great signs and wonders, before he resists the temptations in the desert, before the water is turned into wine, and before he does any feeding of thousands, any healings or raising people from the dead. God is pleased with his beloved child. Jesus didn't earn God's love. He simply is loved as he is. And from this place of being completely loved and accepted, Jesus then is able and full of God's love to go out and do wonderful things. What a gift the voice of God is, the message of God to our hearts. It launches Jesus into his life-giving ministry. When God speaks, things happen. Jesus heard God's love and was compelled to share this love. May we also hear God's voice. And may we see this breath breathe on us of the Holy Spirit And even when we were baptized, maybe we were too tiny to remember, or maybe we haven't been baptized and still thinking about it. Wherever you're at with baptism, may we all hear, you are God's beloved child forever. That's what was spoken over you if you're baptized in an Anglican church. God whispers it, you are my beloved child forever. God thunders it, you are my beloved child forever. And you don't have to do anything to earn it or deserve it. You just are God's beloved child, extravagantly loved as you are. And that you are God's beloved child forever. And with this fullness of love, may we too go out and join God in bringing wonderful blessings in the kingdom of love. You are God's beloved child forever. Please stand as you're able as we recite together the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. The dead. Holy Spirit, Holy Catholic Church, forgiveness of sins, resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Please stand, sit, or kneel as is your preference for prayer.
All loving God, we come into your presence to be with you, to come close and hear you whisper in our hearts. As we begin this new year, help us to slow down and relax into your wonder, your vast creation. Help us to notice the beautiful landscapes, the snow on the mountains, all you have given to us to enjoy. And please forgive us, Lord, for not taking better care of your beautiful earth and all its creatures. We are your people, your light in Chilliwack and the surrounding communities. Fill us with love for each other and those in our community who are in need. Help us to recognize opportunities where we can help. Our world is in turmoil. We pray for your continuing compassion on people who are enduring the violence of war. And we ask that you help those willing to provide water, food, and medicine to those who need it. In faith we pray. In our community, many struggle to provide for themselves and their families. Please meet their needs. We especially pray for those who live on our streets close by. We pray that those with substance use disorder will seek help. We also pray for comfort and encouragement for the families and friends of whose loved ones are held in the grips of substance use. In our families and communities, there are some that are discouraged and sad, and we ask that you will bring them hope and joy for 2024. We also pray for healing for those who are ill or have other needs, and we ask on behalf of the Kowalskis and Joanna. In faith, we pray. We know the sanctuary is precious to you. Thank you for your loving preservation for 150 years. As we begin 2024, we ask for you to guide us as we make decisions on how best to care for this holy place and to plan for its future. We ask you to continue to inspire and guide our beloved priest, Lorie, to bless and encourage our wardens, Jan and Wayne, and we thank you for their diligence and dedication. We pray for our sister churches, the Church of Epiphany in Surrey, the Reverend Stephen Rao, the Christ the Redeemer Church in Surrey, Archdeacon Luista Engang, and we also pray for the Scottish Episcopal Church. Faith we pray. Please encourage all parents and bless them. Help them to teach their children how to play and walk in this confusing world. Lord, with the new double digits program for youth 10 years and up, we ask you to grow this fledgling program and help it meet the needs of youngsters in our parish and in the community. Help our children to grow up strong in the faith, and please keep them safe. May we never cease modeling your loving ways to our children. Lord, we are grateful that you brought many visitors and newcomers to the parish throughout the Christmas season. Please continue to show us how to be a welcoming church. May you fill us with joy that spills over to whoever walks through our doors. All-loving God, you go before us as our light and guide. Help us to willingly follow your light wherever it leads us throughout 2024. In faith we pray. Amen.
Please stand as you're able. Dear friends in Christ, as we continue to turn our hearts and minds to worship all loving God, let us confess any sin. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your name. Amen. Merciful God, grant to your faithful people pardon and peace, that we may be cleansed from all sin and serve you with a quiet mind. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. The peace of God be always with you. Please share a sign of peace with one another.
Precious cornerstone, sure foundation, you are faithful to the end. We are waiting on you, Jesus. We believe you're all to us. precious cornerstone, sure foundation. You are faithful to the end. We are waiting on you, Jesus. We believe you're all to us. Let the glory of your name be the portion of the church. Let the righteousness of God be a holy flame that burns. Let the saving love of Christ be the measure of our lives. We believe you're all to us. Only Son of God, sent from heaven, open mercy at the cross. You are everything, you're the promise. Jesus, you are all to us. Let the glory of your name be the passion of the church. Let the righteousness of God be a holy flame that burns. Let the saving love of Christ be the measure of our lives. We believe you're all to us. Let the glory of your name be the passion of the church. Let the righteousness of God be a holy flame that burns. Let the saving love of Christ be the measure of our lives. We believe you're all to us. You're all to us. You're all to us.
Pray over all. God of life and freedom, we celebrate the revelation of Jesus as the Christ who makes all creation new. Accept all we offer you this day and make us new in Him who is our friend and helper forever and ever. Amen. Table of the church and of God It is to be made ready for those, ready for those who love God and for those who want to love God more. So come, you who have strong faith and you who may have weak faith, you who have been here often and you who may not have been for a very long time, you who have tried to follow and you who may have failed, come, not because it is I who invite you, it is our Lord. It is God's will that those who want God should meet God here. May God be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to God, our Creator. It is right in all times and in all places to thank and praise you, Creator of all. We praise you here where the Fraser River meets the Salish Sea, where city and farm, wilderness and industry are side by side. We praise you at a time when the body of earth is broken again and again. We give thanks for our place in the story of salvation. Our ancestors journeyed with you in creation and migration. They depended on the land, were displaced from the land, and displaced others from their lands. They knew you in tents and cities, on mountains and by wells, in families and in dreams, and through wilderness prophets who spoke of cedars and listened to ravens. Together with angels and ancestors, orca and salmon, bear and raven, salal and cedar, we join our voices with all creation in this ancient honor song. Jesus, whose first bed was a feed trough. He was baptized in the Jordan, tested in the wilderness. He traveled in fishing boats and told parables of farmers and seeds, labor and wages, yeast and bread. On the night before Jesus died, he took bread, food of the poor, the work of field and hearth. He gave thanks and broke it and gave it to his friends, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this to remember me." Again, after supper, he took the cup of wine, fruit of the land, gave thanks and gave it to his friends, saying, "This is my blood, which is shed for you. Whenever you do this, do it to remember me." Remembering Jesus' life, death, and resurrection, and awaiting his coming, we offer you this bread and this cup. Creator, send your spirit on these gifts so that we know Jesus in them, and are gathered together with everyone who shares this sacred meal of justice and community. Fill us with the courage and love of Jesus, that we may strive for justice and peace. Respect the dignity of every human being, and safeguard the integrity of creation. Bring us with all your saints to your commonwealth of sparrow and lily, child and beggar, which is both now and yet to come. All honor and glory are yours, Creator, Christ, and Spirit, now and forever. Amen. As our Savior taught us,
Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Creator of all, you gave us golden fields of wheat, whose many grains we have gathered and made into this one bread. So may your church be gathered from the ends of the earth into your kingdom. Let's just say it together. That's okay. Jesus,
Lamb of God, have mercy on us. Jesus, bearer of our sins, have mercy on us. Jesus, Redeemer of the world, give us your peace. Give us your peace.
Are the gifts of God for the people of God. All are welcome to the table, to the altar rails. I just ask that you come in and move right to the end so people can kind of come in behind you and then you can leave from there. And if you'd like bread, two hands. If you'd prefer a communion wafer, one hand, please. And feel free to drink from the wine or just touch the chalice if that feels better for you. All is fine. And you may stand or kneel at the altar, whatever you like. And please take advantage of this beautiful, blessed holy water and dip your hand in and receive that gift today if you would like.
I will trust my Savior Jesus when my darkest doubts befall. Trust him when to simply trust him seems the hardest thing of all. I will trust my Savior Jesus. Trust him when my strength is Savior Jesus. He has said his way is best, and I know the path he's chosen leads to everlasting rest. Jesus, only Jesus, help me trust you more and more. Jesus, only Jesus, may my heart be ever yours. Jesus, only Jesus, help me trust you more and more. Jesus, only Jesus, may my heart be ever yours. Oh. Thank you.
is welcome anytime. Let us pray. Gracious God, lover of all, by this sacrament, you make us one family in Christ, one in the sharing of his body and blood, one in the communion of his spirit. Help us to grow in love for one another and to come to the full maturity of the body of Christ. We ask this in his name. Amen.
Amen.
Please stand. Let us pray together. Glory to God,
whose power working in us
can do infinitely more than we could ask or imagine. Glory to God from generation to generation, in the church and in Christ Jesus, forever and ever. Amen. And out of the fullness of Christ's love, may you receive grace upon grace, to know how deeply you are loved, and to know the presence and power of the Holy Spirit unto you to do what is yours to do in the world. And the blessing of God, our Creator and Christ and the Holy Spirit, be amongst you and remain with you and those you love always. Amen. For coffee over at the hall and some goodies too.
So dark that your eyes cannot see, there's light so bright as as we look to our Savior, life more abundant and free. Life more abundant and free. Turn your eyes upon Jesus. Look full in his wonderful face. And the things of earth will grow strangely dim in the light of his glory and grace. Lord, our God, you are with us in darkness. Your word, your light is leading us on. Our hearts can hear you, Heavenly Father, calling us all to your Son. Calling us all to your Son. Turn your eyes upon Jesus. Look